Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
To our family and friends, thank you for coming to help us in the celebration of eternal love of Melvin Sykeson and Dr. Shuby Kibbe Reed. It all began as a fairy tale that now comes true. Shuby Kibbe Reed attended James Madison High School in Dallas, her hometown, from 1962 to 1966. Melvin was a student at her rival high school, where Shuby's mother served as one of his teachers. One day in 1964, a group of young men asked the mother the following very important question: does your daughter, Shuby, have a boyfriend? Without a blink of an eye, she responded, "Yes, Melvin Sykeson." As she pointed his way, Melvin was just as shocked as everyone else in the classroom, but he soon asked for her name and number, and eventually showed up at their doorstep. A week later, and her mother brought him in, showed him Shuby. She was over taking her piano lessons, and she said, "Shuby, this is Melvin. Melvin, this is Shuby." Shuby and Melvin fell in love instantly. They spent hours talking about music, lyrics, school, and dreams. Later in life, both decided to go their different ways, and sometimes life has that condition, we all go our separate ways. Amen?
Amen.
But if life would have it, they finally found their way back 55 years later.
Yes, it was.
At Shuby's mother's funeral. During her life, she united them together, and at her death, she brought them back together 55 years later. So they're here today to commit their eternal love together. And so let us get on with this celebration, and we don't want them to wait another minute. Amen?
Amen.
After 55 years. So it would be fitting for us to offer prayer. So let us pray in Jesus' name. Eternal God, creator of life, we thank you for life, we thank you for living. We ask our blessing, Father, upon this couple. We ask that you bless and sanctify them with your Holy Spirit. We thank you, precious Father, Shuby and Melvin, for their spiritual connection with their parent, a couple that you ordained, and we believe this. We thank you for this gathering, this celebration today. Grant that they may give them the vows to each other, and we thank you for strengthening them in their steadfast love, enable them to grow together and to present to the world that they are the light of the world, and that they give light to each other and to this community. This we pray in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ's name. Amen.
Amen.
Jason, please help. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Come on, let the church say amen.
Amen.
From 1 Corinthians. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful or proud or rude. It does not demand its own way. It is not irritable, and it keeps no record of being wronged. It does not rejoice about injustice, but rejoices whenever the truth wins out. Love never gives up, never loses faith, is always hopeful, and endures through every circumstance. When I was a child, I spoke and thought and reasoned as a child. But when I grew up, I put away childish things. Now we see things imperfectly, as in a cloudy mirror. But then we will see everything with perfect clarity. All that I know now is partial and incomplete. But then I will know everything completely, just as God now knows me completely. Three things will last forever: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of these is love.
Amen. As we forgive our debtors, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever.
Thank you. Mr. Melvin brought Dr. Reed a pair of silver slippers. That she's wearing today?
I'm going to get around to everybody, but I better change shoes first.
Points me in the right direction. She's that kind of person. I would not have been. Several years ago, I had a situation where I had a mild stroke, and I was amazed by the fact that she was able. It happened in Florida.
Right.
I had come for a 3 or 4 day visit and ended up staying several months. But in any case, she was not only able to get me to the hospital and take care of me, but her youngest son had some problems. So there were two people in the hospital. She did everything she needed to do, and she still had energy to do more. So this may displease a lot of males in the room, but I would have to say that you guys, females, may be made of the same part of the cloth, but you're made from a very, very distinct situation. So this lady, I love her very much. Even though she's retired, she really cannot retire.
Right.
She's not that person. And I think that in some respects, the old saying about the best things are saved for last, given their relationship years ago, it is a gift of God that they have come together at this point in their lives. I want to see them do some of the things that she wants to do. She wants to travel and what have you. I think he'll be a helpmate, a partner, what have you, in the best sense of those words. So I salute Trudy and Mel. And also I ask for God's blessings for them in the years to come. I hope they have many, many happy years together.
Amen.
I know that Trudy has looked for the right person, and I think this is the right person, and that's definitely a gift of God. Salute.
Salute.
I told her when I heard the word retirement come from her mouth that John Paul, the apostles, did retire. This lady is a prophet. When I met her in 1964, after I was introduced to her, I saw the halo over her head. That's why I backed away. Because as I told her, I did not want to mess up your life. Because I knew that she was ordained for greatness and good things. And I know where my troubles were heading. And like I told her, you are top shelf, okay? And I did not want to be responsible, as I told her, for messing up your life. Now, when we reconnected 55 years later, May the 26th this year, I explained to her, I never thought that I would get a chance to explain to you why I step away from you, because I didn't want to mess up your life. She immediately turned and snapped me up and said, you or no one else could have ever messed up my life, because I already had my goals planned. And all during that meeting, it was the same thing. And looked like what happened, I was back at 16, 1964. And I was trying to catch up with her, taken all the way up to 55 years, and she was looking at me kind of strange. And then I asked her a question. I said, well, would you get in trouble if I write you? And she looked and snapped me up. and said, I can't get in trouble because my husband is dead. And I explained to her that my wife had passed on the 23rd of February 2014. And so she pulled out her card and wrote the address on the back of it. But I don't know anything about your state. And I said, Port Orange, Florida. And she snapped again. Yes, the state where the oranges grow. And, you know, we know that she's somewhat snooty. She'll tell me, I mean, she's really hilarious to me. She said, we're going to have a discussion. Well, okay, that's what we're going to have. That's all I want to say, but she's a joy. She's my joy. She's my heart, my spiritual mate, and this was ordained because I never would have figured this. You know, am I deserving? If you ask me, I would say probably not, but I'm blessed. Thank you.
Je suis française. Yes, I met Trudy years ago. Her son was in my class at school, and she needed some help with him after school. As we just stayed friends for that for a while. She went to, well, the rocks. I went over there and see her one time, just before she came here, as a matter of fact. Because I had a van and my granddaughter Gina, and I carry all the plants across the country. But the good one is, when she came here, it was Hurricane Charlie. During Charlie, we didn't have no light, no gas, no nothing. But we still kept on working. What happened after Charlie was over, she decided that we're going to go get a manicure and a pedicure. That was a good one. We get into this shop, and this little girl was sitting in the middle of the shop. He waved, and he ignored her customers. But she put me out with this guy to start doing something. And she looked at her, she said, well, I guess I'll do your nail. Okay, and then we started talking, we were close to each other. And she asked Trudy, she said, how do you know her? Well, she's my sister. I didn't know what to say because I never heard Trudy say a thing all these years. And I said, but laughing. I couldn't laugh. I had to stay straight. But after that, the girl said, well, who's the parents? You don't look anything like each other.
Okay.
Oh, wow.
And she said, well, that's my father. He was overseas. She's never been raised here. She just came here for a visit. Still looked at me and looked at her. She kept insisting, what are you doing in Port Orange? She told her, she said, well, I'm here because I like this state. Never told her she was the president of the university. But it went on and on and on. I mean, that girl was not stopping. Then when she finished with Trudy's nail, she put on somebody else to do the pedicure. But she was very snooty. And we've been friends over these years. I mean, sometimes we don't see each other for months. But it's part of life. Mm-hmm. And if she needs me for anything, I'll be there. She knows that. Mm-hmm. And it's the same thing to her. She's a great and the best friend. I wish her all the love and happiness in the world.
These three, but the greatest of these is love. I certainly honor the Lord Jesus Christ and his love that is in this place to everyone in your respective places. I am so blessed and honored, appreciative of this opportunity to be here to celebrate love with you. I met Dr. Reed in 2004 at Bethune-Cookman University, and we were quickly drawn to each other because, first of all, her love for education. I've known since I was a little girl that education was my ministry, and to see such a powerful woman devoted and committed to education, I knew that it was God sent, and quickly, we recognize that we both love the Lord Jesus Christ, and that helped us to work so harmoniously together. And I have learned so much from her. My life is so much better because of her love for education.
Mm-hmm.
And from education, I then discovered her love for excellence. We were preparing for SACS accreditation at the time, and as president of the university, it was nothing for her to put on sweats and get on the floor, literally get on the floor, hands and knees, and go through files, do whatever was necessary to ensure that the university was embracing excellence. And the level of excellence that was achieved under her leadership cannot be erased. And for that, I'm
grateful.
And then I think what I admire her probably the most, in addition to education and excellence, is her love for everyone, which is so evident by the diversity that's represented here today. I've never seen her look down on anyone or shun anyone, even though she has so much to offer. Her arms and her hands have always been open to help. Students felt comfortable in coming to her office. Faculty felt comfortable in approaching her. She loves everyone, and I'm just so happy that after all of this love she's given to me, to the faculty, to staff, to students, to everyone, now she has someone to share a different level of love with. I'm very, very happy for the both of you. You deserve it, and may God continue to give you the desires of your heart. And thank you from my family, from myself, for everything that you've done for us. We are eternally grateful. Through you, I've met the Honorable Dr. Cusack, the Honorable Dr. Reverend Bracey, and so many more. And to be able to travel abroad because of your leadership, I wanted to be here today to say thank you so much.
Well said. Well said. Salute.
I met Dr. Reed walking the halls of the Florida House of Representatives. As a legislator, Dr. Reed was there as the president of the great Bethune-Cookman University.
Hear that.
And she always was intact in what she had to say. You know, legislators don't like to listen too long. Every time she came to my office, she already had the agenda set. Mm-hmm. What she was expecting from the Florida House and from the state of Florida for Bethune-Cookman University and historically black colleges. I respect her for the fact that she is an outstanding person who is can sit and dine with kings, but also can go under the tree and talk to the young ones about education.
Hear that.
She was never too big or too little to be involved and engaged. And so, I'm here today because it's nothing better than to say to my friend, I wish you well on this journey as you open another chapter in this great book of life. So in 2004, I journeyed to Bethune-Cookman and she bestowed upon me an honorary Doctor of Laws degree.
Hear that.
At that mighty, mighty Bethune-Cookman University.
All right.
And so I, as a member of the Volusia County Council, I continue to embrace the lessons that this great woman has taught us. And now she deserves to have some time to do something for Trudy.
Mm-hmm. Right.
It's so befitting that you would be here today and to share the love of your life as you go into the sunset and just have a good time.
Yes. Hear that.
Just enjoy life. Enjoy every minute, for life is good, and we love you. Hear, hear.
Yeah. Well said. Well said.